Good evening, everyone. In the previous session of Global HRD, I was explaining about the subsystems of HRD. And I have explained around 6 or 7 points. And the remaining points I'm going to explain in today's session. And then I'm going to explain the potential appraisal. So in today's session, I'm going to explain the remaining points of HRD subsystem. And then I'm going to explain about potential appraisal. Okay, so let's begin the session. So these are the remaining points of HRD subsystems. So the first one in today's session is quality circle. So quality circle simply means a group of people doing same type of work. And what they usually do, they meet once in a week or twice in a week for certain number of hours through which they can discuss with each other about a particular task or about a particular product or about anything. So with a proper discussion, they can come to a conclusion regarding any kind of problem they are given. So that is called quality circle. A group of people doing same kind of business, same kind of job or similar kind of job, they are going to meet on a regular interval for discussing about a particular situation or finding or trying to find out a solution to a problem. So these people will interact with each other. They will communicate with each other. If there is some kind of disagreement, they will try to come to an agreement regarding such kind of points. So that is the actual meaning of quality circle. Okay, so why do companies organize quality circle? Because when we are working in an organization, obviously we are working as a team member, as a group member. So interaction with other group members are very important. Working as a team is very important. And when we are working as a team, when we are interacting with each other, definitely we are going to produce or our performance will be of better quality. So for that reason, quality circles are organized. It helps employee to properly communicate with each other. And even if there is some kind of conflict, they can discuss about it. They can try to resolve the conflict. So with the help of quality circle, they are not only understanding about they're not only going to understand about conflict, as well as they are going to understand how to resolve a conflict in a healthy manner. So the basic purpose of quality circle is to boost confidence in the employees, help them to interact with each other, and also it helps in better interpersonal relationship. So these are the various reasons due to which quality circle is organized or executed. And this is also one of an important part of HRD. This is one of the important part of HRD, because with quality circle, it leads to development of the people who are part of those quality circle. Because when we interact with other people, when we discuss with other people, we try to understand the point of view of many people. In that sense, our thinking is broadened, our mind is broadened. So we are open to understanding and listening to various types of point of view. And when they are trying to justify their opinion and point of view, we can also understand how one person thinks and how their point of view can be more effective than our point of view. So it helps in better understanding, it helps in creation of a healthy working environment, and it also helps in better interpersonal relationship. And that's why it is also an integral part of HRD. So it is also one of the important system of HRD. The next one is role analysis. Now, each and every employee has a particular type of role which they are supposed to play within the organization. Because when one person is appointed on a job, that person has to do the job efficiently and properly. And that is his or her role to play. If a person is appointed in the position of a clerk, he or she is expected to play the role of a clerk, do his or her job properly, efficiently, effectively, so that work in the department, work in the organization can move in a, or they can operate in a smooth way, or work will be in a very proper manner and everything will be executed in smoothly and without any kind of interruptions and without any kinds of hurdle. So every person has a particular kind of role to play in the organization. And for that reason, the management needs to understand what is the role of each and every employee. Because on the basis of that role only, they can compare the performance, they can do performance appraisal, potential appraisal, and various other elements. So role analysis is also an important part of HRD system. Now, as a person, when some kind, as an employee, when some kind of difficult situation arises or challenging situation arises, people may not be able to understand their role properly. They may not be able to manage the situation, manage the job. So this usually happens when one person does not have the potential, personality, attitude for doing a particular kind of role, that is doing a particular kind of job. So in role analysis, they need to understand the role of a person which he or she is supposed to play while on the job, what kind of personality is required in order to play that role, what kind of attitude is required, what kind of behavior is required, the level of knowledge, skills, and each and every element is necessary to play different kinds of role. So every role has its particular requirement. So they need to find out what is the role of a particular job, whether the person is capable enough to play that role or not. So that is that helps in the development of employees, that helps in increasing the knowledge and providing necessary skills to the employees. So for that reason, role analysis is also an important part of HRD. The next one is human resource planning. So obviously, when there is HRD, there has to be human resource planning, because first of all, the organization needs to collect information about the existing human resource, the total number of people working within the organization, their qualification, experience, their potential, their capabilities, skills, knowledge, each and every element related to each and every employee needs to be collected. All the information needs to be collected, so that they can understand whether the company has those kind of people who are required by the company. And if the company does not have that kind of people having that kind of potential and capability, then what needs to be done in order to match the requirement of the organization with the potential of the employees. And that leads to human resource development. Because after understanding the present potential capabilities and competencies of a person, a human resource development program can be prepared. And if existing human resource do not possess certain qualities, certain potentials, or certain abilities, they need to find out people from outside the organization having those qualities and potentials so that the organization will run smoothly, it can operate efficiently. So HRP is first of all understanding the basic requirement of the organization in terms of human resource, and then finding out whether they have those kind of people, where whether they have that number of people working within the organization to match the requirement of the organization. And if they do not have, they can go for different types of development program to enhance the potential and capabilities of the employees, or else they can find those kind of talented people from outside the organization. So that's why HRP is also an essential part of HRD, because it helps in creation of different human resource development programs. Okay, the next one is procurement and placement. So after planning about the requirement of human resource, how many number of people are required and what kind of qualification experience they must have to become part of the organization, after finding those information, now it is time to search for those candidates, those people who can fulfill the requirement of the organization. So that is the procurement process. Through recruitment and selection process, they will try to find out suitable candidates for the job. Those candidates will go through many processes, many steps, many types of interviews and tests, so that they can prove their capability, they can prove their competency to the organization, and then they will be placed within the organization, and according to their qualities, according to their personality, attitude, qualification, experience, knowledge and skills, they will be placed within the organization. So procurement and placement is also an important part of HRD, because these elements reveal the exact potential capability of a person, and according to that future HRD programs can be prepared. Okay, the next one is job rotation. You must have heard this term in training. One of the methods of training, job rotation means one employee will do various types of job within a specific time period, within a specified time period. So for in one job, the person will be placed for 1 or 2 months, then again the person will be placed in another job for another 2 months. Like this, the same person will do variety of jobs so that the person can understand the difficulty level of each job. The person can understand how to manage each, means many types of job. So that will help the person to develop, because the person is not only doing one type of job, but the same person is doing various numbers of job in different time period, for different time period, 1 month, 2 month or 3 month. So that will enhance the knowledge and skills. The person will be more efficient. The person will be ready to manage any kind of job because that person has already done different types of job. So job rotation also helps in development and growth of employees, those who become part of job rotation. Okay. And the next one is quality of work life. Now, when we are working in an organization, one of the most important part of working life is the working condition, which is provided by the organization. So every employee needs a stress-free working environment. They need a healthy working environment where their problems can be solved, where their issues can be heard by the management. So the management needs to provide a healthy working environment so the people can concentrate on their job, they can focus on their job, they will get different types of benefits and incentives, they will be appraised for their performance, they will be appreciated for their contribution. So all these things contribute to a quality of work life. Healthy working condition is provided, and this will ultimately lead to the job satisfaction. So these quality of work life is also very important for HRD, because as a person, when I am working in an organization, I expect to have a healthy working environment. Some people focus on other elements, but healthy working environment will help you in lot of way. It is going to help you to focus on your job. It is going to help you to create healthy working relationship with others. So no matter what kind of salary, what kind of position you are having, but if a person does not have a healthy working environment, an efficient person's performance will also start to degrade or decrease. So that's why for the development, for overall development of human resource, quality of work life needs to be focused. And for that reason, it is one of the subsystems of HRD. So these are the subsystems of HRD. Okay, now I'm going to explain about potential appraisal. What is the basic purpose of potential appraisal and why organizations need to have potential appraisal. Okay. So potential appraisal basically refers to the evaluation of present abilities which are not currently utilized by the employee, or these are not required these qualities are not utilized or they are not required to that extent for the present job. So each and every job requires certain knowledge, certain skills and certain potentials. The person may have higher potentials, but those potentials are remained unutilized because it is not required for the present job. But it does not mean that the person's potential may not be utilized in future. And for that reason, potential appraisal becomes necessary for every organization. Because even if a person's potential may not be required, may not be utilized in his or her present job, it may be more beneficial if the person moves to a higher position, and that potential may prove to be beneficial for the organization as well as for the employee. Okay, so here it says that if the potential is not utilized or not required in the present job, but it may be required, it may be possibly required in future higher position job, which the person may be holding in future. So that is the meaning of performance appraisal. Evaluating the present abilities, present potential, overall potential of the employees. These potentials may be utilized to some extent or may not be utilized at all also. So finding out the potential is necessary so that the management can understand to what extent a particular employee is capable of doing. So that after understanding this, that person can be promoted to a higher position and the actual potential of the person can be utilized in that higher position job. So that is the basic meaning of potential appraisal. Okay, so it also refers to the appraisal and identification of hidden potentials, abilities and capabilities also. Because sometimes as human beings, we haven't tried all the things in our life. And we start assuming that the things that we haven't tried, we are not good at that. But that does not mean to be true. Sometimes we have potential, but sometimes we are not even aware about that also. So potential appraisal is not only about finding out the true potential, but also finding out the hidden potential of an employee, of the employees. And there may be chances that the employees are also not aware of it. So those potentials can also be utilized by the organization for its benefits. And when a person is recognized with his or her potential, then definitely the person will be appreciated. The management will try to improve his or her potential so that the person can move ahead in his or her career, can move to a higher position and prove to be beneficial for the company. So it means identification of hidden potential and also evaluation of present potential. So one of the definition is given in this regarding potential appraisal, that it is a process of determining an employee's strength and weaknesses with a view to use this as a predictor of his future performance. Means it determines the present strength and weaknesses, and then it helps the management to predict the future performance. For example, a student who has very good history, who has obtained good marks in the previous courses, whether it is 10 plus 2 or plus 3. So it reveals that this person will definitely achieve good marks in masters also because of the past potential and strength and weaknesses. So potential appraisal helps in determining the strength and weaknesses. And this helps to predict the future performance of the employee because it will reveal how well the person is going to perform with these potentials in future. So this is the basic meaning and definition of potential appraisal. Now, potential appraisal is very important for HRD because like performance appraisal, potential appraisal also focuses on those elements which are left out in performance appraisal. Because performance appraisal focuses on the actual performance of the people, past performance, present performance, but it does not focus on the real potential of the person. A person may be having higher potential, but with lack of support from the organization, from the superior and subordinate, the potentials are not utilized by the person. So that may be the reason. And for this reason, potential appraisal has become an integral part of HRD because it helps in understanding the real true potential of the employee. Then it helps to enhance the potential so that the person can grow, develop, get knowledge and get different types of skills so that the person can be eligible for future higher position. So potential appraisal is not only beneficial to the company, it also extremely important for the individuals who are working in the organization. It helps them in lot of ways also. Okay, so this is the basic meaning or introduction of potential appraisal. Now I'm going to explain what is the basic purpose of potential appraisal. First of all, to inform the employees about the future. How potential appraisal is going to inform the employees about the future? Now consider yourself as an employee And with proper potential appraisal, different types of your capability and ability is revealed to you. Now, with those understanding of capabilities and abilities, you try to picture yourself in future in a position that with this potential and capability, I may reach to this position, I may hold this position in future, because these potentials and capabilities are extremely necessary for those jobs. So potential appraisal reveals the true potential of every employee, tries to find out the hidden potential, and then these informations are communicated to the employee and they can understand what kind of future they are going to have with this potential and capability. So it helps in informing the employees about their future. The next one is to help the organization to chalk out a suitable succession plan. Now, after understanding, after collecting information about the potential of all the employees, the management can clearly understand the strength and weaknesses of the existing workforce. And with those information, they can create future plans for the organization. Future plans, like they can develop different types of training and development program. They can also plan for growth, for expansion or diversification of the organization after understanding the competency and capabilities of the employees. So it helps the organization to plan for the future, because an organization's success depends upon the quality of workforce they have, means what kind of workforce they have. If they have good workforce, trained, highly capable, high level kind of people who are very intellectual, who know what they are doing, who are capable of doing much more in their job. So with that, with those number of people, with those kind of people, the organization can definitely create a plan for itself, create a future plan for itself. So it helps the organization to plan or create succession plan for the entire organization, plan for growth, development, diversification or expansion. The next one is to update training methods from time to time. So potential appraisal reveals the true potential, true capability of the employees. So this helps in creation of training program. Training methods are updated from time to time, because people are changing, they are developing, they are growing, their capability is increasing. So obviously training methods are also needed to be changed from time to time. So after understanding the actual potential of the employees, the training methods can be replaced by new training methods within a particular time period. If the training methods are not useful for those kind of potential, then new methods should be utilized. So it helps in updating the training methods used in the organization. The next point is to advise employees about what must be done to improve their career prospect. So as a person, you are aware, you are made aware about your potential, talent, capability and everything. So with this information, you can plan your career according to it. You can the management can also help you to guide you in your career. So with those information, the management can provide important advice or create a career plan for you, create a career path for you, and that will lead to your future career. So it tells you what you are supposed to do in order to improve yourself and develop yourself to have a successful career. So it also helps in giving advice to the employees. Okay. So these are the basic purpose of potential appraisal. Now I am going to explain why organizations need potential appraisal. So these are the reasons because of which every organization and every HRD department requires potential appraisal. So first one is creates competitive environment. So when we understand our true potential, when we also get information about the capabilities of our colleagues, then it creates a very healthy working environment by creating healthy competition. We try to compete with each other for a future position so that we will get a raise in our salary, we will be appreciated for our performance. So it contributes in creation of a healthy working environment, which is helpful for the employees to give competition to each other. And this thing is done in a very healthy manner, because if you understand that there are few people who are having the same type of capability and potential that you have, so definitely there will be a competition. Each and every one will try to prove themselves, and in this competitive environment, their performance will keep on improving. So that benefits the organization as well as benefits the employees. Okay. The next one is healthy organizational structure. So potential appraisal helps in many elements, like creation of a career plan. Career development is also focused by the organization. So each and every employee tries to understand what true potential they have. So in that manner, they contribute more towards the organization. A healthy working organization structure is created, where management considers the potential of the employees, gives them those kind of job in which their potentials can be utilized. So an environment is created where it creates an environment where people try to have healthy working relationship with each other. It enhances the relationship between employer and employee. It enhances the relationship between employees, and that leads to a healthy organization structure. The next one is attract and retain best talent. So with potential appraisal, the management is able to identify people with exceptional qualities, people with intelligence, people with excellence, and they always try to retain those kind of people within the organization. So it helps to identify best talent within the organization, and by providing different types of facilities and the types of job in which they will prove their potential. So that will help the organization to retain best talent within the organization. Because if they fail to identify potential talented people within the organization, definitely they won't be able to satisfy those employees, and ultimately after a particular point of time, they are going to leave the organization for better opportunity. So keeping the talented employees within the organization, potential appraisal is very useful in that process. The next one is inform employees about their future prospect, which I have already explained in purpose of potential appraisal, that it informs the employees what kind of future they are going to have with these present potentials, how they can develop their potentials, and how these potentials are going to help them to move ahead in their career. So that is one point. Next one is updating to career and development program. Because all the career and development program are based on the employees, the real potentials and exact capability of the employees. After that, they are creating those kind of programs. So it gives necessary information for making necessary changes, necessary modifications in the training and development program, so that the company won't be repeating same kind of development program, which may prove to be useless for the employees as well as the management. The next one is advise employees. So with the information of potential appraisal, they can advise employees about their career, how to plan their career, how to create a career path. So it helps them in development by providing useful, or we can say valuable, advice to the employees. The next one is motivate employees. So when you understand what is your true potential and what you can achieve with that potential, it motivates employees, it gives them confidence, it helps them to focus on their job, contribute more towards the organization, and ultimately their performances improve. So this is also another reason because of which potential appraisal is extremely necessary for every organization. And the last one is create a succession plan. Like I said, when the organization is aware about the capability of the entire workforce, they can create future plans for the organization, whether it is expansion, diversification, or taking over another company, starting a new brand, or starting a new product, those things. So with because like I said, like I always said, that the success of the organization largely depends upon the kind of workforce the company has. So if they are aware about the potentials, capabilities of the workforce, they can easily plan for their future, and these plans can also be properly executed with the help of the talented and efficient employees. Okay, so these are the various reasons because of which every organization need to have potential appraisal. They need to conduct potential appraisal within the organization. Okay, so this is all about potential appraisal and what is the basic purpose and need for potential appraisal. In the next session, I am going to explain what is the process or method of potential appraisal, how it is important for the organization, and various other elements. Okay, so that's it for today. We will meet in